this to our room. He'd be the voice of him. He said that we would thank him.
Wow, a modern pop video in more ways than one. Have a look at this. The pictures and the sound are all on compact disc video, and everything about these discs is highly complex, the way they're made and the way they're played. But complex though it is, it's a perfect example of how modern technology can be perfectly understandable. Now, each one of these discs holds about 6 minutes of video information and about 20 minutes of stereo sound. However, adapting the system, you could get up to 32 hours of speech on one disc, or using it as computer storage, as much information as you get on 1,000 floppy disks, or 150,000 pages of paper. And all that on just one side of a disc this size. So think how much information you could pack onto both sides of a disc this size. And how is it done? It's all digital. These machines convert information into digital information, sort of coded information. Why? Well, with the old vinyl discs, to lift the information off the disc, the needle would scratch its way around the grooves. And with each scratch, you get a slight deterioration in quality. With LaserDiscs, it's different. You've got coded information on here, and even if that information is distorted slightly, when it's read by the laser, the same codes are lifted off, so you get very little deterioration. The question is, how do you capture the coded information on the LaserDisc? Well, that's done by reflections. The initial production processes take place in a dust-free environment, because the slightest speck of dust would damage the recording. It all starts with a glass plate, which is coated with a very thin photographic film, and that is etched by a laser guided by the digital information, so it acts on only certain parts of the film. The film is photographically developed and then silvered to produce your first master disc. And now reproduction starts. Alan. The disc is placed in a bath of acid to produce the first copy. It stays in there for 2 hours. It's coated by a 0.3 millimeter film of nickel. And there is your first copy, a master and a copy. And they need to be separated. And the copy is then used to press new masters. Those masters will produce new copies. And it's these second generation copies that will be used to press the discs that will go on sale. And here they are being pressed under 200 tons of pressure. Then the two halves are sandwiched together with the information on the inside under a thick layer of clear plastic. Why? For protection. These discs can be pretty roughly treated without affecting the information on them. Why? Because they're read by laser. And that acts rather like the camera looking at me now. It's focused on me and doesn't see the glass in the window between us and the blemishes on it. Similarly, the laser is focused on the disc and doesn't see the blemishes on the surface. I hope that's perfectly clear. Now, it's a simple question of playing the disc. When I say simple, first of all, we've got to establish exactly what we have on this disc. The information on these discs is packed 60 times more densely than on a normal long playing record. The track is 31 kilometers long, and it's made up of tiny pits. What do I mean by tiny? Well, this ruler is 300 millimeters long. There's a millimeter, the tiniest division on the ruler. Yet a pit is only 1/2000th the width of a millimeter. Very tiny indeed. With the electron microscope, we can actually see the pits. There they are. And the distance from there to there is still only 1/40th of a millimeter. Now you can see the pits are all varying lengths. That is the code that gives us our information. And the pits are also not very deep. Each one is only 1/10,000,000th of a meter in depth. So how does a laser read these pits? Well, the beam of the laser is very, very fine indeed, and normally it's reflected off the surface of the record. Now, if it falls into a pit, it's diffracted. It doesn't reflect back. In effect, the beam is switched off. Then it reflects again, and it's switched on. Falls into another pit, and it's switched off again. And this constant on-off switching of the beam produces your code that reproduces the information on the disc. an illustration of just how much information can be stored on these discs, have a look at this. This is the BBC Doomsday Interactive Video Project. And on just two of these discs, there are 56,000 photographs, 10,000 articles, 2,000 essays and other text items, as well as 60 minutes of video and maps on six different levels covering the whole of Great Britain. There's no doubt about it, besides already revolutionising the pop and recording industry, LaserDiscs could revolutionise teaching, become the greatest teaching aid ever devised. We could all learn something. I've learned something already, and I'm sure from these discs, I'll discover more. Discover more? What a disgusting jocularity.